Seidel. We've known her pretty much all her life. And watched her grow from this big to this big. And center stage has been a big part of it. She's really blossomed, become very outgoing through this process. She's enjoyed it, back playing soccer, and just so far has had a great time. It's been a big month for her. She's graduated, she's turned 18, and we're finally getting rid of her. Her mom is a little bit excited, but I think we can get her to say something.
Yeah, I never thought that it would be so nerve-wracking to come actually up here and talk.
It has to be heard.
Are you excited? I'm crying every time.
Then it has to go up like that.
So I'm good. I have next week, so nothing is shaking me at all, and I guess today it finally does. I remember when Emily went to her very first recital, and she came home and she goes, "Oh my God, Mom, I'm going to have me one of those." So that day is finally here, and like David said, Keely, you've been such a blessing in our life, and her life, and to so many kids within your program. So thank you so much for giving her a home outside of her home for the last 14 years. As she always says, center stage kids don't get in trouble, they're in rehearsal, and it is definitely true. I think I said enough. So
let's
have a show, have some fun.
A dream is a wish.
whole tide roller coaster. Here we go.
Florida, Orlando, I am ready with you.
Day one, I've set a goal for me. One box seat, I got allowed to be. I wasn't scared, I found the sun my own.
I think I invited every single one of you, but I'm so excited for all of you to be here. I've been at Center Stage for, about 14 years of my life. I've like grown up with all these people, and I'm so super excited that all these people are here joining me on stage. And I'm so lucky that all of you are here to watch me, so I hope you enjoy. I don't need this, so I'm gonna pop this off stage. It's okay. We changed a lot for my show since yesterday. So anyway, this next person who's coming on stage is one of my bestest friends, Ava Holguin, and I've known her for the past forever years of my life, since she's been at Center Stage. And we're so close, and I'm so lucky to know her, and this song is actually the first duet that we ever sang together at Center Stage in Lights. And we didn't know the choreography then, so I don't think we're gonna know it for you now, but I think we sing it a lot better now than we did then, so I hope you enjoy. This is Why Am I Me?
Tell you what I'm thinking, honestly and true. How come I come to life as me and not to life as you? Lord, I know the feeling, 'cause when I'm by myself, I wonder why I'm who I am and not somebody else. Way down Emily, why am I Ava?
right, a little walk down memory lane for sure. This next song, I've never sang it before, but it is with two of my very close friends, Mr. Riley Smith and JoJo Crago. Wow, this is so exciting. So, this next song, I hope it doesn't go over your head. It's gonna be really funny, and I'm so excited. I hope you enjoy.
So, how are we getting there?
Beach slot there, slogging, fogging, stooching, scrooching. I hope you don't hold it against you.
Well, I'll try not to.
Hitch those horses up for a gay ride. We'll have lots of fun. Nothing's better than a hayride underneath the sun. Roll, roll, roll in the hay. Sometimes love finds a way. You might steal a kiss from an unfitting miss who's not too resistant to play.
Roll, roll in the hay. We'll go up the path, then down the hill, then up the path, back down the hill. We'll go up and down and up and down and up and down and up and down.
Push the horses up or down, and we'll have
fun.
Down and up.
Well, as I said, my name is Keely Milliken, and I am the proud voice teacher of Miss Emily Harvey. There are so many, so many, so many memories over the last 14 years together. You can check those out in the lobby, I'm sure, during that intermission and all the stuff that Emily's been posting on her social media from throughout the years and all the lovely videos. She's made all of these videos. She's put together this whole night. We're just here to facilitate and help her. It is her show, and she's doing an amazing job at putting it all together. And graduating, all of that. So when I met Emily, she was taking dance, and then she also wanted to sing, and I met Sonia, and she came up to me and said, oh, we want to be in your beginning voice class. I'm like, you have to be 8. That was before I went all the way down to 4. Like, I don't have. But I said, you have to be 8 years old, and she's only 6. And then she said, well, let her sing. And then she came up and sang something for me. And went, yeah, I think I can make that work. And she joined beginning voice class, BVC, that we like to call it. And we were about to go to, that semester, we were going to go to Disneyland and do a performance there. But you had to be 8 years old in order to go backstage in the Disneyland. And I'm like, Emily, you have to lie. You have to tell everybody that you're 8. And of course she did, and we had a great time. That's just one of the many, many memories. Another memory I will never forget of all the many, many voice lessons. Of course, we have a studio space now, but This is our 23rd year at Center Stage. And for 20 of those years, I taught voice lessons at my home. And we have so many wonderful memories together at my house and then in our back house, and all these fun videos that keep popping up of rehearsals with Emily and Tessa and Megan, and then Hamilton's rehearsals, and they're just adorable to watch them practice and grow and have such a great time together. But something I will never forget about Emily Harvey is that no matter what show we pick or what song we pick and we work on for 6 months, that will not be the song that she sings at the performance. She likes to change her mind. And that's okay because it has given her so much a chance to be able to really dive in and learn songs quickly. And I can trust Emily with anything. She'll learn it, she'll do a great job. So thank you, Emily, for all of that. A part of the senior recital experience for Center Stage Ians is to be able to sing in classical music every year and also sing in a foreign language. So tonight, Emily and her friends are going to sing, along with Emily, some different songs in Latin and also in French. Enjoy.
Used to live alone before I knew you.
So glad Keely made me sing it, and I hope you enjoy it.
Dear, 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 dear
friend Tessa Barkley over there. She's going to stay up on stage with me. So I've known Tessa forever. I think we've probably been at Center Stage probably around the same time. You know, I'm a little bit older, so I might have been here like 1 year longer. I got that. But we sang this song when we were 10, which is a little odd. And we were wearing these like sparkly, tight, like jumpsuits. Like, I don't know. I don't know what the look was there. But we're going to bring it back tonight for all of you. I don't know if we're any sexier now than we were then, but maybe we can try. We can try.
Maybe I'm just crazy, maybe I'm a fool.
said, I've been in center stage for a long time. So that's a lot of Monrovia days and a lot of different shows. So I sang this song my very first Monrovia days in, I don't know, 2011, maybe 2012, really long time ago. And just recently in May, I sang it for my last Monrovia days, because it might have been the only song that I could like pull out on the spot too. But it's a really cute song, and it means a lot to me because I've been here forever. So this next montage of songs, it's gonna have a lot in it. It's gonna be a lot of different shows, a lot of different songs, a lot of different characters. And we're gonna start it off with Seussical, which is the first center stage show I did in 2011. And I hope you enjoy my first medley. This is the cat of the high, everybody.
Just speak from the planet of Boo, and the smallest of small, to the jungle of Nool,
and the largest of all.
You think and 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 think. Just speak! All the things you can think, think and wonder and dream, far and wide as you dare.
Candlelight by twilight, and Steve will look just like a little tail. Well, it wasn't really little, it was absolutely giant, and it really was exciting, but you never even noticed, so I felt a little silly even trying. Besides which, the tail was too heavy for normal flying. Well, when the hunters caught you, I could see that I'd been foolish. No, I couldn't even help you. No, I couldn't even fly. And I got so very frightened because I knew I had to save you. No one else was going to go through all the labor. It was all up to me. All you had was your next door neighbor.
You ran to the doctor.
The doctor named Dave.
And he said,
my tail has been a mistake.
And he said,
Dr. Dave, I've been foolish of me. Plug it out. Get it off.
Pluck, pluck, pluck.
Ouch, it hurt a lot.
Pluck, pluck, pluck.
Ooh, a tender spot.
Pluck, pluck, pluck.
Just a one feathered tail. But suddenly, your twinkling sail. I sailed on a junk and was practically sunk.
You got it.
Yeah. I recommend walking around naked in your living room.
We made that video in 2020 during the pandemic when we weren't allowed to go anywhere, but Center Stage stayed open except remote on Zoom. So we all did singing class on Tuesday night from our bedroom in our rooms, like by ourselves, singing on the computer. It was such an awkward time, but from that time came amazing memories like that video, and then later you'll see one more video from that time as well. That was super exciting, and I hope you enjoyed that video. That song is very special to me. So next up, I have another medley for you guys, another musical montage. Except this time, these are all roles that I've played from I think about 8th grade to the last role I just played in November, which was Belle in Beauty and the Beast. So, without further ado, I hope you enjoy. Continuing continuing our live coverage from Central Park, where no evidence has yet been found of the UFO that apparently crashed in the park earlier this evening. Perhaps what you millions of New York One viewers saw was Santa Claus making his rounds.
That's exactly what they saw! Except Santa's sleigh crashed because there's not enough Christmas spirit anymore.
Looks like one of Santa's elves joined us. Nice times.
Put some cheery bolero on every wall and every nook. Tints up each corner till it's Christmas everywhere you look. Give the world a holiday that's bright as can be. Make it
thank you.
Anyway, it's time to get rid of this.
Can't you just see it? Madame Gaston, his little wife.
But I know you can still hear me. So anyway, this next song that I will be singing is Home from Beauty and the Beast. All right, here's a face with voice. Anyway, the next song that I'm going to be singing is Home from Beauty and the Beast. From Beauty and the Beast. We're singing on the same note. So I'm sure everybody knows, I was Belle in Beauty and the Beast in November, actually. Sorry, I'm so thirsty. So that was the best time of my life. I had the most fun in that show. All the people, all the numbers, being Belle, like, come on. That's all you can ask for. And after playing Belle, it's safe to say, and I could definitely say from my heart, that was definitely a dream role in the skies, I guess. Like, that was so much fun. The songs are so much fun. And so, I'm going to be singing another song from Beauty and the Beast. This is my favorite song in the entire show. It's called Home.
Yes, I made the choice. For Papa, I will stay. But I don't deserve to lose my freedom in this way, you monster! If you think that what you've done is right, well then, you're a fool.
Return to the life that I knew.
also wanted to say a little something, because I forgot to say it earlier. I choreographed this entire show by myself, actually. Obviously, a little up in Huey, but I hope you guys like the way it looks. And shout out to my amazing cast. They're killing it. If you guys can hear me, you guys can hear me. Amazing! But now, this is one of my dearest friends, Hannah Corey. And I've known her forever. Again, she's been at Summer Stage forever. And we've definitely gotten so close over the years. And I'm so lucky to know her. She's amazing, a gem, one of my favorite people ever. And so tonight, we're gonna bring you my favorite song from the show Glee. So anyways, this is my dad. I love him so much. Definitely one of my number one supporters, and I'm so thankful for him. And he's gonna kill it on the guitar. He always does. And this song that we're gonna be singing is Me and Bobby McGee. It's by Janis Joplin. And this one is for my other grandma, my Uma, who's also not here with us, but she's still here. You get the idea. But yeah, I hope you enjoy this. A little country-esque vibes.
There you go. Yeah. Got one of the last pleasures of an old man. His daughter for you.
Busted flat in Baton Rouge, waiting for a train. When I was fearing ears faded as my jeans, Bobby thumbed a diesel down right before it rained and rode us all the way to New Orleans. I pulled my harpoon out of my dirty red bandana, eyes playing soft while Bobby sang the blues. Windshield wipers slapping time, I told Bobby's hand in mine. We sang every song that driver knew. Freedom's just another word for nothing left to lose. Nothing. Don't mean nothing, hon, if it ain't free. You know, feeling good was easy, Lord, when you sang the blues. You know, feeling good was good enough for me. Good enough for me and my Bobby McGee. From the Kentucky coal mine to the California sun, there Bobby shared the secrets of my soul. Through all kinds of weather, through everything we've done, yeah, Bobby, baby, kept me from the cold. One day up near Salinas, Lord, I let him slip away.
Too many times that I've
last video that you saw, like I said, during the pandemic, we still did class, just over Zoom. So that was me and my dad again, and we sang My Church for the musical marathon. And up next, we're coming close to the end of my show, wow. But now I'm gonna sing with the one and only Miss Keely Milken, and I'm so excited. I hope you enjoy. I don't wanna cry. No, not yet. So I hope you enjoy.
Makes it all clear.
it sure would be nice to be back home, where there's love and affection. And just maybe I can convince time to slow, giving me enough time in my life to grow. Time be my friend, let's restart again.
Sure about it.
mind this is. Okay, I am back. I'm gonna drink some water. And I'm sure y'all expected it. This is the part of the show. This is the part of the show where I'm gonna say thank you. Jason looks weird. He's just sitting in the middle of the stage. Anyway, okay. It looks hidden. No one can see it. So, anyway, so there's been so many people who have helped make this show possible, and I'm so lucky, I'm so excited, and I'm so happy all of you could be in my cast. So first people I want to say thank you to are my amazing cast. They're amazing. They're great. Thanks for helping me make this show. And it was pretty chill, like, most of the time. Except, like, yeah, it was pretty easy. We just did some rehearsal in my driveway. It was pretty fun, and you guys made it even more special and even more fun. And I'm so lucky to have shared the stage with you, because although it is my senior recital, it's not just about me. It's about every single one of you too, because you got me twirling right now. I'm here, and I'd like to say thank you to all of you who came to watch me. Thank you so much for being here. I'm so happy. All people love me one place watching me perform. What's better? Anyway, the next two people I'd like to thank are Alexandra and then Amanda. They're the two lovely ladies running Spotlight for me. Thank you so much. I appreciate you so much. I've been giving gifts like everybody before this, so they're not leaving home empty-handed. And then shout out to my guy JoJo. He let me borrow his speaker for every rehearsal. Woo! Next up, we have Miss Melissa, my stage manager. She helped me change. All my pretty outfits, and she made her pretty quiet. She's amazing, I'm so grateful for her. Then we have Mr. Mark Mello, who took photos yesterday. He's taking photos today, but he's always on it. Half the photos that you saw in all my slideshows, shout out to him, because he's definitely taking most of them. Next, we have Ms. Dawn Stone. She's recording the show, so I can watch it later. Shout out to her, thank you so much. And we have Angelo. He did all this pretty lighting. Thank you so much. I'm so thankful for shooting with you. It looks amazing. It looks amazing. I love it. I love it. Then we have Mr. Holy, the big guy. I've known him forever. He's been doing sound for every show, even though he's retired every year after every show. He's somehow still here, but I'm so glad he is, because I couldn't have done this without you, Ho. Thank you so much. And then, I have one more. I'd like to say thank you to all of my friends and all of my family for always supporting me and coming to watch me in my shows. You guys are the best, and I couldn't do without you, especially my parents, even though I'm mean sometimes. But I love you guys. You're the greatest. Thank you so much for everything. And last but not least, Keely. I've been doing center stage since I was a little wee lad. And I remember the first day I walked into class, I started crying because I was really scared. And I thought, first of all, I did not think Keely was who she was. I thought she was someone else. So I had like a vision of Miss Carla. If you know Miss Carla, that's what I was thinking of when my mom told me I was doing singing lessons with Keely. Completely off. But I walked in there and my life has been changed forever, changed for the better. And I'm so lucky that I've been getting to do theater, and I've gone to do theater all my life, all these years. And it's sad that, like, after this, I'm kind of, like, done with center stage. Like, I graduated. Wow. Crazy. But I'm so thankful for you, Keely. I know you, like, I can see you a little bit. I can see you a little bit. There you are. Thank you so much for all the years, all the songs, all the I'm going to change my song a week before. Like, I mean, even for this, I probably changed a couple songs like last week. That's okay. And thank you for always letting me stay in your show, even though I would always, like, be late. I'm always late. Or I would be like, oh, I'm actually going to do this today. Can't come to rehearsal, sorry. And all my soccer games, too, that I had to miss rehearsal for. But yeah, thank you so much. I'm so lucky to know you. I'm so lucky to have you in my life. Thank you for everything. And on that note, thank you again to every single person in my life. I'm so lucky to know all of you guys. And thank you for being here tonight. I have one more song to send you home with. Woo! That Arizona sky, burning in your eyes. So I will see every single one of you out there. Thank you so much.